Pull your wing through the Bernie trick. I'm not used to taking that off. Mm-hmm. Right side up. Yeah, you've got it. Here. It's all set. Oh, isn't it pretty? It's gorgeous.
And he's, as you can see, that his whole body is all rusty brown kind of color. And you'll see that if you looked up thrushes in your book, your bird book, you'd see that we could have a Swainson's thrush, a gray cheek thrush, a hermit thrush, or one called a veery. Those are all thrushes beside the wood thrush that we might get here at the Nature Center one time or another. Veeries stay here to breed, and so do these guys. These wood thrushes will breed here. But hermit thrushes and the gray-cheeked and Swainson's are all headed up north. Veeries are probably my favorite singing bird because veeries have a wonderful call. It's very echoey. It sounds like moist woods. Somebody says it sounds like somebody's singing in a rain barrel, you know, or in the bathroom where you get all these echoes, and it's just a sound like that. And the hermit thrush is similar, only they go up instead of down. But the thrushes are marvelous singers. So this is a wood thrush, and they're in trouble as far as numbers because they like woods that are not interrupted by roads and trails and roads and people and farms and stuff. They like big tracts of big woods, and our woods, our forests are all getting fragmented to such a degree now that wood thrushes are getting less and less common. But if you go on a bird hike, you're probably going to hear them singing today. I heard them sitting here, so they've got to be around here somewhere. So we're going to look up wood thrush, so I make sure to get all the data. Since they are a thrush, they'll be right here in my, I think it's this way. Eastern bluebird, there's a thrush. But this one is a wood thrush. Here's a veery, that's not going to help us. Swainson, hermit. Gray cheek. Wood thrush. There we go. All right. Now, wood thrushes look exactly the same. Boy, he's really jumpy. Wood thrushes look exactly the same as both the male and female. That's what my thought was. Both male and female look exactly the same. There's really very little difference. Again, the male might have a little bigger, longer wing, so he might get to the breeding site a little faster than she will, but they look just about exactly the same. Okay. Can I get one?
Oh, yeah.
All sorry. Right. Now, this has got a bit of a bump on the vent, and that's called a cloacal protuberance. How about that for a $50 word? It really means a bump on the bottom. And you know that birds breed by what they call a cloacal kiss, which I think is very descriptive, tells you what happens with them. A little sex education here, but anyway, so this time of the year with chickadees and some of these birds that are exactly the same physically, you can blow on the vent open and then you can see if there's a bump there. That's a cloacal protuberance, and that'll tell you it's male. Probably the champion is a song sparrow. The male song sparrows are very obviously male, but this one I believe is a male. I measured his wing before, and sometimes with sparrows and some of these other birds, you can actually you can tell if they're male or female by the length of their wing. It's a 102. And I don't think that's big enough, though, to be, nope, it has to be over 112 to be definitely a male. I think with a CP. How are you doing, honey, huh? How are you doing? Good. All right, we got to think about what we're doing here. 1A tells me exactly what size band to use. And here's all my band sizes. And all I have to do is find a 1A. Okay, what am I going to write on here? What is he?
Can I get out there?
What kind of thrush? Wood thrush, right. I think I gave you about 7 different kinds of thrushes it could be, but because he's rusty brown all over his body and he has pretty big black spots, whoops, gonna have to make it a little bigger for you. There we go.
So even though the wing length didn't measure as male, it's still a male.
Yeah, yeah. Mm-hmm. They give you anything over 112, I think it said, will be definitely a male, and anything under 96, I believe it said, will be definitely a female, and then you have all the middle. And that this one has enough of a cloacal protuberance to make him a male. And I'm going to double check his number.
Can you get my camera?
28. That's right. Now the whole number, in case you're wondering, the whole number is 158165628, all on this band. So you have to make sure that you're using the right brand, the band that you say you're using.
So you ordered them by their band numbers.
Yep, and you get them at 100 on each string of bands, and the sheets have exactly 100 on there. And as soon as you're down to the bottom, then you start a new band, and hopefully it's in sequence. It's a lot easier if it is. One thing about thrushes, they have this little tiny, see this feather right here?
Mm-hmm.
This is called a vestigial feather. You're getting all kinds of terms today, aren't you? Just like school. Anyway, it's called a vestigial 10th primary. On other birds, this would be as big as the other primary feathers, but with thrushes, this vestigial primary will tell us a story later this year. This one tells me that this little short, skinny, pointed primary this fall will tell me that this is an after-hatching year bird rather than a hatching year bird, because this one will be a different size for the young birds. Now, why nature does that is anybody's question, but it's very convenient in the fall when you're trying to age birds to have little tips like that.
Did it for you.
And that comes from a lot of study by some guy who's getting his, usually guy, sometimes girl, who's getting their doctorate in ornithology or something. So. And what did we say it was? What did I say it was? I forgot. 103, wasn't it? 102? 103. Let's do it again. When in doubt, do it again. Let's put 101.5 when you can't decide. Today is 6-9-07 CC Rock. Rock on. All right, this fella's ready to go, and we know they're singing in our woods right now, so if he hasn't started nesting, he is about to. Now, who hasn't released a bird that would just love to release a bird?
Yay. I would.
Okay.
Would you like me to take it?
Oh, yeah, that'd be good.
Is it easy enough to get?
Yeah. Okay. Now, this one might lay still for us, because he's not used to being on his back.
There we go, yeah. Okay.
Oh,
we're in net, so we're thinking they might be.
Or fighting. Yeah, that's what this is. See, this is another.
Oh no, I'm revised over there now.
See, this is another wood thrush. Yeah, this is nice coloring on this one. Very clean and lovely. This is called a wood thrush, you people that are just arriving. Very nice bird, one that we're kind of worried about because their numbers aren't what they used to be, but as we lose forest, we lose what lives in them, and this is a wood thrush. And I might as well put a band on this one since we've got all the bands right here in front of me. Stick his old leg out there, slide on the band, hold it with my fingers. It's a bigger band, so.
It's a nice bracelet out of the deal.
Yeah, he does, and one that doesn't rust or corrode, and often will last longer than the bird will.
Yeah.
We've had bands found in owl pellets, because we're getting a big enough group that maybe we better sit down and everybody can see it. It's up to you, though. Would you rather just stand?
I guess
it's up to you.
Hens dig it.
Yeah, well, whatever. They're kind of like a collar on a dog. For the first while, they'll peck at it and try to get rid of it, but then they'll forget about it after a while, and so he'll just ignore this. But this is, again, like everybody has seen, this is the wood thrush. This is the second one we've picked up now. And if you have been doing some bird walks, they're singing in the deep woods. And that's the reason their numbers are down, is because our forests are getting more and more fragmented. It's smaller and smaller groups, numbers of trees in a forest that get smaller, broken up. So he has a band on. Now what I want to do is measure a wing. This is a wing cord, yeah. Now this is definitely a bigger, this is 105. Okay, this is definitely a male. This has a cloacal protuberance, as I was just talking to some of the group about. It sticks the cloacal area, that's the vent, or the where the waste and the eggs and everything comes out, or sperm, depending on the sex of the bird, of course. But this is sticks way out on the male this time of year. Otherwise, you couldn't tell males from females. They're exactly the same color. But the cloacal protuberance will tell me that this is a... I think I will change this one to a U, because it sure doesn't stick out that far.
What's
this one, U means unknown. And until she's sitting on eggs, the females won't have a brood patch. So it's really, that's the only way you can tell females from males, is if they're on eggs. There. This is 105. Wood thrush, today's date, my name, place, there we go. And there he is, ready to roll. He's gonna go back out in the woods and sing his song and make sure that all the wood thrushes will stay away so he can raise his family. Now these guys haven't had a chance to do it. Yeah. You wanna try it? Just to put your hand out and make a bed? No?
I
None
do.
Of you? Who
I
does?
Do.
Or higher up, you back there, you'll try it. Come on a little closer. Now remember, when you're finished though, you have to use, where's that cleaner?
Right there.
Oh, there it is. You have to clean your hands after, all right? Now, don't drop him, huh? He'll might just lay there for you.
You're being pulled, so.
There you go. There you go.
Have you had a real little bird lately?
No.
This one, did she give you a hand
up? Oh. Witchy, witchy one. The song goes, witchy, witchy, witchy. Oh. Boy. Oh. No, this one's not. This one.
No, that's not, but that's good.
I know
anyway.
That
this
way.
Is a good one anyway. Anybody know what it is? Raise your hand. You know what it is? What?
I think it's an Oreo.
No, Oreos are orange. See, orange.
Black headed chickadee?
Oh, that's close. He does have a black head, I'll tell you that, but he's not a chickadee.
He's gold.
He is gold colored. So what do you suppose? What bird has gold in his name?
Goldfinch.
A goldfinch, right. And this one happens to be an American goldfinch, because there's a European goldfinch that lives in Europe, of course. So this is an American. Oh, and this is a nice bird. See how pretty his black wings and tail are? Now, if you saw this guy this winter, he'd be green and olive colored and brownish. But he'd still have his black wings and tail, so you can tell him from his mate. She's got dark brown tail and dark brown wings, and she's quite olive colored. She's not bright yellow like this. This one, some people call him the potato chip bird. You know why? Because he flies along in a kind of a loopy flight, and he goes, potato chip. Potato chip. Mm-hmm. He does have a pretty song though. He sings, and the finches all have a nice song. So he does have kind of a warbling song. What's neat about them is they nest late in the summer, and they use thistle down in their nest. You know, where the thistle plant bloom with that purple flower, and then it goes to seed, it makes kind of a fluffy white flower, kind of seed head, and they'll use thistle down in their nests. And somebody told me that their nests are so well built that it'll actually hold water sometimes. So she, mom would have to make sure she's sitting on their babies when it rains. Don't you suppose? Yeah, I don't know if that's true or not, but one thing I do know about goldfinches is if you went to Arkansas and at the end of April and the first part of May, you would hear goldfinches in the trees down there so loud you can hardly talk to your neighbor. They're singing so loud down there. That's where all the young goldfinches go for the winter, is down there. The parents might stay up here all winter, but the youngsters will go down south. Smart. Now, we're the other way around. All the kids stay in Minnesota and all the parents go down south in the winter time. All right, this little guy is already banded. He already has a band on his legs. Oh, whoops, took some. There it is. See, it's got a little silver band. Little silver band on his leg. Now, I caught one of these guys in the spring one time, and he already had a band on his leg, and he'd been banded in Arkansas the winter before. So it was kind of neat to find a bird that's already banded. I'm going to make sure that I recorded him. There. No, I guess I haven't. 9548. Let me double check. 9-5, yep, I already recorded him. He's all recorded and ready to go. Now, you already let one go. Now, do you want to let one go? Okay, you saw how easy it is? Now, he might just lay there for us. Nope. There he goes.
It's just, it was right by my eye.
So we can get a picture of it. Yeah.
Oh, okay.
For Tom's article.
Okay. Let's go. Here's another kind of bird. Now, this one is this is a bird that you hear more often than you see. This time of year, you'll walk along in the woods, and pretty soon you'll hear a very loud voice in the woods all saying, "Teacher, teacher, teacher." That's because teacher, teacher, teacher. And that'll be this bird. But he's like many of the robins and things that we look at, you can see that he's on the ground quite a bit. He's nice big legs. And he nests on the ground and he gets his name. One of the only birds I know that is named for the way his nest looks. He has a nest that looks like one of those ovens that they use in the South when they break tortillas and things in them, I think. Anyway, it's a round nest with a hole on the side and laying on the ground. So, and that's what his name for the nest. He's called an oven bird. An oven bird. They give birds funny names. I know a bird that sounds, his call is meow, meow. So what do you suppose they call him?
A cat.
Yeah, so see, they give, sometimes they make names that make sense. Sometimes. This is an oven bird. You can see he's got a little orange on the top of his head, a little black stripe. That's a neat little bird. Now the male and female look exactly the same, oven birds. Can you think of a bird where the male looks different than the female? Ducks. Which duck do you think of? Okay. All right. Now let's see. Now I happen to know that this bird is a member of the warbler family. The warbler family, right here. And I'm going to look it up and see if I can find oven bird, because sometimes they will fool you and they'll use a little bigger bird's band size. I think this is a 1, isn't it? Or 1C. Yeah, you don't want to use too small a band on these. It makes a very big mess if you do it. Oven bird, there we go. It says 1C. It's a 1C. Now I get to use my special bird banding pliers. Now, I bet you'd be able to see better if you wanted to all go sit down. Why don't we do that since we're getting to be a good sized crowd? Close that up. Don't want it to be out. Don't want it to catch on anything. Want the bird to just ignore it. Yes.
Like the bird?
Nope, just like my bracelet. It just slides on his leg.
No,
see, because it's round. It flips it round instead of flat. So we don't do anything. That's one of the first rules of bird banding is don't hurt the bird. That's number 1, capital letters. First rule of bird banding, don't hurt the bird. Yeah. Yeah. There's nothing there, all nice and...
Can I ask a question? You mentioned with the yellowfish that the bird had been tagged in Arkansas?
Well, not this one, but I have had one.
Do you have some kind of a system to track where
That's a good question. When you get a bird that, like for instance, if you get a bird hitting your window, this is all recorded in the computer, and we just download to a main computer in Washington, D.C. with a bird banding lab down there. Interior Department runs the show. And then they send you back a notice that bird had been, because you can recognize your own bands, you know,
right.
Use them all the time. And when you get a strange one, you turn in a special, you can either call it in or email it in. And took the band off her leg, and I mailed it to the bird banding office in Washington. They sent me a nice certificate, told me that bird had been banded, that one in Arkansas as well, and had been banded by a guy named Pratt 3 years before. So it's kind of a fun, that's the way we can all contribute to the program, so they know what happens to the bird. Now, as far as that little goldfinch is concerned, I picked him up in the spring, and then I sent in my little pink slip, and they sent it back. He said he'd been banded down there in February. So. Anyway, I was going to measure a wing here. This is one measurement we always do. There is a
7.5.
7, yeah.